UDC Firebirds basketball fans, and welcome to another edition of UDC Firebirds basketball here on University of the District of Columbia Television. I'm Eli Perlstein, and this afternoon we have doubleheader action for you as both your men's and women's basketball teams take on Daemen College. This is the first conference matchup for both the men and women. It is the second home matchup for the women this season, as they look to get their second win of the season and their first win here at home for new head coach Juan Dixon. He's the former Maryland standout, and he has got a very young team here at the University of the District of Columbia that he's trying to guide through the rigors of the East Coast Conference. Conference play again starts this afternoon against the Daemen College Wildcats, who come in with a record of 2-4. Now our own Eric Zidalis talked to the head coach of the Daemen Wildcats, and here's what she had to say about coming here to the District of Columbia and facing your UDC Firebirds.
Thanks, Eli. I'm here with Daemen head coach Jennifer Banker. Jennifer, this is one of the longer trips you have to make to play a team in the ECC. Is this one of the hardest places to win in the conference?
It's my first year, so I have to just be honest with you that I'm just, in terms of going to the different places, just now experiencing that. So I won't be able to answer that one for you.
Okay. Your team is 2-4, 0-1 in the conference heading in. What have you seen from the Firebirds team in film?
They look like they're a team that penetrates real well, and they like to run in transition. So it looks like a team that works together well as a team.
Okay. What do you guys have to do to get a win today?
I think we've got to play good defense, and we got to box out, got to stop their penetration.
Thank you, and best of luck today.
Thank you.
Eli Perlstein back with you, and it looks like we are set to finally get underway after a bit of a delay because the stats computer wasn't turning on or wasn't functioning properly. But looks like they have gotten that fixed, and we are set to tip this one off. First conference game of the season for your UDC Firebirds. Firebirds last season went 15-5 in conference play, on their way to an overall record of 21-9. Their fourth season with 20-plus wins since the start of the 2011-2012 season. They went 12-4 at home last season. As the tip is up, and it's won by the Wildcats. That was Jaslyn Rollins taking the tip for UDC. Daemen can't keep the ball in bounds. It'll be UDC Firebirds basketball. First turnover of the game. 9:52 to go here in the first quarter of play. Remember, this was the big change last year that women's basketball went to quarters as opposed to halves. Rebound deflected out of bounds, and it will be Daemen basketball. Daemen last season went 4-8 away from home. They were 7-13 in the ECC. They finished 8th out of the 11 teams in the conference last year. This year, just 10 teams in the conference. Saba drives, dishes wide. McDonald the three, no good. Rebound by Rollins for the Firebirds. This is a Daemen team that has a couple of very good three-point shooters. Oliver has it on top of the arc for UDC. Step inside the arc, her shot rims out. And rebound deflected out of bounds. Last touch by Deja Anderson, so it's Daemen basketball. 9 minutes exactly to go here in the first quarter of play. Still scoreless. Firebirds entered this season predicted to finish in eighth place in the ECC. Daemen predicted to finish in ninth. The two teams that coaches in the conference didn't think all that highly of coming in. A golden opportunity for the Firebirds to get their first win at home this afternoon against the Daemen team that has lost four in a row. Three-pointer launched from the left side and netted by Kaya Coleman. So Firebirds up early here, 3-0 for Coleman. That is her fourth made three-pointer this season, fourth in 22 attempts. A junior from Laurel, Maryland, she's averaging 5 points per game. She transferred to UDC from Shaw, the only transfer on this year's team. Answering right back with a three of her own, however, is Jordan Heinold. And we are knotted at three apiece. 8:14 to go here in the first quarter of play. Appreciate you tuning in. You're on the University of the District of Columbia Television Network. A traveling violation called on Jasmine Rollins. So it remains a 3-3 ball game. Sydney Jones takes it up court for Daemen. Dribbles right, now dishes left into the hands of Jesse DeWaters. Saba drives to the free throw line, kicks back to Miles, who pass intended for DeWaters, out of bounds off of the fingertips of DeWaters. So UDC basketball, 7:44 to go here in the first quarter of play. Here's Coleman, dribbles right, picks up her dribble, got stuck, but able to bail her out is Rollins. Now Oliver, screen set by Rollins. She drives left of the lane and gets fouled on the attempt. So Chantrell Oliver will head to the line for two. As I mentioned earlier, Oliver missed all of last season due to injury. Juan Dixon happy to have her back for her senior year as she sinks the first free throw. Comes into this game a 69% free throw shooter on the year. She's averaging 9 points per game, third most on the team to date. She gets them both, and it's 5-3, UDC on top, 7:25 to go. Wide open down low is McDonald, and she hits the easy lay-in from the left side. She found the hole in that UDC press and was able to capitalize. Oliver trying to answer, drives left of the lane, her runner too strong. Rebound hauled down by McDonald. Daemen with numbers. Jumper from the left side, no good from Jones. Rebound to the Firebirds. Now they push the pace. Oliver going to the rack again. Again too strong. Saba back the other way. She cuts into the paint and a beautiful finger roll to put Daemen up 7-5. The both teams not afraid to get out in transition. 6:33 to go here in the first quarter of play. Oliver uses a screen set by Rollins. Now the three from Coleman. This one misses everything. She hit her first three-point attempt earlier. Saba gets whistled for the offensive foul. Push off. That is team foul number two for the Wildcats. The first personal called on Sarah Saba, the Wildcats' leading scorer, a junior from Lancaster, New York. She was a member of the first team All-ECC a year ago. And just on Monday, she was named to the ECC Honor Roll. Short baseline jumper, no good off the fingertips of Deja Anderson for the Firebirds. Now wide open for three is Liz Miles. She comes up short. Rebound snared down by Anderson. Oliver drives, cannot finish with the right hand, but draws the foul. So clock will stop with 5:38 remaining in the quarter. Now everyone in gold on the court besides Oliver will go to the UDC bench and huddle up around head coach Juan Dixon. Oliver hits the first free throw to make it a one-point game. Just topping off the Daemen bench is Karina Pringle. She will check in, replacing Sydney Jones. First sub of the game for either team. Oliver perfect from the free throw line thus far. We have a whistle and a free throw lane violation called on Niaja Anderson. Niaja Anderson also receiving an honor on Monday. She was named the East Coast Conference Rookie of the Week. Before the shot, travel is the call on Saba. So back-to-back turnovers for the Wildcats. Oliver brings it into the front court. Hands off to Adeja Anderson. Now Coleman. The screen set by Rollins. Swings back to Oliver. Coleman playing give and go with Adeja Anderson on top of the arc. Now gives off to Oliver, who settles for the step back J from the free throw line and connects. Makes it 8-7, Firebirds on top. 4:56 remaining. Nice answer by McDonald. Drive from the left side. Banks it home. It's a 1-point Wildcat lead. Next stoppage in play will be our first media timeout of the ball game. Oliver, just inside the arc, lets one fly, cannot connect. Rebound hauled down by Jesse DeWaters. Miles kicks out. Now the pass into the paint, broken up. Oliver ahead to Niaja Anderson. Oliver gets to the elbow and passes out. They're working around the perimeter. Good job closing by Saba. Didn't give Coleman much room to shoot the three. Now an offensive foul called on the Firebirds. That is their first team foul of the quarter. And we have the under five media timeout. With the Firebirds trailing by 1-9-8. You're watching University of the District of Columbia Television.
Being a champion takes more than skill, more than endless drills, more than using your head. Being a champion takes the heart to give it your all, the agility to thrive from any angle, and the relentless drive to be the best. Welcome to Division II, where the pursuit is yours to create. And the question isn't, can you do it? It's, will you?
We're building an advanced public system of higher learning that serves the community of the District of Columbia. We selected all of those words very carefully because they all have important meanings. Because none of it really works unless you have a public higher education system that can connect it all together. Well, one of the best kept secrets about the University of the District of Columbia is that we have many quality programs. Our workforce development unit is of a high quality and puts people in jobs each and every day. Our land grant unit, which is serving constituents all over the district, we're the only urban land grant institution in the country. I think that we have all the pieces that we can put together in a way that will allow us to take best practices, best tools, and really wipe the slate clean and redesign ourselves as an advanced public system of higher learning that can serve the district in a way that allows us to be a model of higher education in a city that wants to be a model city for the rest of the country.
Back out of the timeout as the Firebirds trail by 1-9-8. Looks like the same five on the court for UDC. So the Wildcats try and look to increase their lead. McDonald works it around the perimeter. Daemen 0-6 against UDC since joining the East Coast Conference at the start of the 13-14 season. Last time these two teams met was January 29th of last year here in DC. UDC won that game 73-57. Sub in for Daemen. It's Jordan Heinold who checks into the game, replacing Liz Miles. Heinold, a freshman from Hamburg, New York, one of five freshmen on this Daemen team. accompanying 8 returning players. A lot of these freshmen are getting some serious minutes. Saba, the 3, rims out. And we got a jump ball on the floor. Possession arrow favoring the Firebirds. Saba averaging 15.8 points per game this season. Oliver drives, dishes, 3 from the corner off the side of the backboard. And loose ball recovered by the Wildcats. Now it's McDonald ahead of the pack, and she puts in the layup while falling to the ground. Makes it an 11-8 ball game. 3:01 to go here in the first quarter of play. Oliver, just inside the free throw line, comes up short. Long pass, able to be tracked down by McDonald, but then she steps on the baseline. So another Daemen turnover. And Firebirds, another chance to get within one or even tie things up. Traveling violation called on UDC. That goes against Bianca White, freshman from Silver Spring, Maryland. She attended Bethesda Chevy Chase High School. So back-to-back turnovers by both teams. And the score remains 11-8. Heinold can't handle the pass, loses it out of bounds. .215 to go here in the first quarter of play. Firebirds playing just their second game at home this season. Daemen playing their 5th straight on the road. Firebirds, good ball movement around the perimeter. Deja Anderson works it to Oliver. Anderson has it back again to Oliver. The 3 comes up short. Firebirds have been chucking up a lot of threes this season. They rank 24th in Division II when it comes to 3-point field goals attempted. They've shot 173 of them prior to this game. Firebirds trying to snap a 2-game losing streak. Daemen trying to snap a 4-game skid. Offensive foul called on Daemen. Team's 5th. Sub in for UDC. Bailey White checks into the game. She replaces Oliver. Bailey White, the leading scorer in the Firebirds' last game, which was on Wednesday night at Shippensburg in Pennsylvania. They lost that game by a final of 70-33. Anderson, whistle for the travel. She dragged her pivot foot as she looked to pass along the baseline. Just 1:20 to go here in the first quarter. Low scoring first quarter of play. Sub in for Daemen. It's Rachel Pollock who checks in. Now watch for Pollock to look for some 3-point opportunities. She ranks 1st in the ECC in 3-point percentage. Matt Bucket makes it 13-8. Daemen on top by 5. Searching for their 3rd win of the year. White, nifty move to get in the lane. Gets it off to Rollins, who puts in the layup from the left side. Makes it 13-10. 3-point game with 48 seconds to go in the quarter. Saba works around the perimeter. Back to Saba. Now the 3 from the near side. No good off the fingertips of Heinold. Firebirds secure the rebound. About a 1-second difference between shot clock and game clock. 3 from the right corner. No good off the fingertips of White. Shot clock now turned off. Heinold spins, has the ball deflected out of bounds. Clock stops with 13.9 remaining in the quarter. Deanna Tunstall checks into the game for UDC, replacing Deja Anderson. Pollock to inbound. He gets it in. Pringle hits the mid-range jumper, just 5 seconds remaining in the quarter. 5-point game. The just past half-court heave comes up short. And at the end of one quarter of play, UDC trails by five. It's 15-10. Daemen on top. You're watching UDC Firebirds women's basketball here on University of the District of Columbia Television.
I have the best job of anyone I know. I am surrounded by intensely committed, hard-charging lawyers for social change, lawyers who care about social justice, staff who are here at the law school because of our mission. Our law school has a completely different, pervasive educational methodology. We learn by doing. So instead of taking a course where you read books and articles about juveniles enmeshed in the criminal justice system, at the David A. Clark School of Law, you represent children charged with crimes or children who are in the abuse and neglect system or children with special education needs in court or in administrative hearings. You actually, as a student with close faculty supervision, change their lives. And that's how you learn.
From court to court and lane to lane, under the lights or under the sun, no one delivers Division II sports like NCAA.com. The center of D2 is inside the NCAA.com hub, with exclusive highlights of every sport and live broadcasts of every Division II championship, found nowhere else. Make NCAA.com yours. The home of Division II college sports.
We get quarter number two underway here at the UDC Sports Complex. Firebirds trail by five in the early going, and right away we have a jump ball called. Possession arrow, I believe, favors the Firebirds. Indeed, it does. The Firebirds able to force the turnover out on the floor to start this second quarter for UDC. We've got Kaya Coleman, Bailey White, Amber Bryson, and Deanna Tunstall. Firebirds in a 2-3 zone to start the quarter. Pollock works it around the perimeter. Pump fake by Pollock. Now dishes off to Pringle. Zone working effectively as the Firebirds come away with the steal. It was Deanna Tunstall who got the strip. 9:19 to go in this second quarter of play. White nearly had it poked away. Now it's deflected out of bounds. It will stay UDC basketball. Firebirds in the gold jerseys going left to right across your screen. Liz Miles checks back into the game for Daemen, replacing Jordan Heinel. Is Tunstall to inbound. Gets it into Coleman. Coleman brings it between the circles. Now swings left to White. Coleman gets it back, works it around the perimeter, three on the shot clock, as White had to let that shot fly, comes up short. 8:52 to go here in the second quarter. Saba, cross court pass to Pollock. White nearly came away with the steal there, just inches from getting her hand on the ball. Three-pointer is in and out. Rebound to the Firebirds. Tunstall coming away with the rebound. Firebirds defense has been good this afternoon. Now they just need their offense to get going. And a travel violation is the call on Bianca White, sister of Bailey. Bailey White will check out of the game. Chantrell Oliver checks in for her. Oliver really the only one to get much going offensively in that first quarter. Jaslyn Rollins checks back in as well, replacing Amber Bryson after a quick breather. It's Jesse DeWaters to inbound for Daemen. Holland back to DeWaters. Now Saba. Pump fake by Pringle. She thought about it, then thought better of it. Now the three from the right corner. Pollock too strong. Misses everything. Holman will slow down the tempo. She works against Saba. Now Oliver will set up the offense. 16 on the shot clock. Bucket good off the glass by Bianca White. Chance at a three-point play by White. White came into this game averaging 9.1 points per game, but cannot complete the three-point play. So it's a four-point game, 16-12. Pollock fishes out to Pringle. Pringle trying to figure out how to beat this 2-3 zone that's been so effective for UDC since the start of the second quarter. That's a way to beat it. Shoot over it. Heinold does just that. Makes it 17-12. Bianca to Oliver. From just outside the free throw line. Can't get it to fall. Saba drives to the elbow. Kicks to Heinold. Can she make it two in a row? No, she can't. Firebirds collect the ball, the board. 6:58 to go in the half. Holman, before the shot, a travel violation. I don't think that was on Coleman, actually. I think it was on Oliver right before the pass. So it will be Daemen basketball. McDonald to inbound. And we have a whistle before that inbounds pass. And I think a warning on Firebirds head coach Juan Dixon. Maybe being out of the coach's box area right in front of the UDC bench. Just a warning. Juan Dixon. Very excited to get his first head coaching opportunity. Really said he didn't care if there was at the D1, D2, D3 level, women's or men's. After spending the last few years as a special assistant to Maryland coach Mark Turgeon, just happy to be at the helm of a program. He's got a young team to work with here in the UDC Firebirds. Foul on Jaslyn Rollins called. The team's third. The third person on Rollins, so she'll have to take a seat. Amber Bryson will come in for her. It was Daemen who was committing most of the fouls in the first quarter. But here in the second quarter, UDC with three team fouls, just one for the Wildcats. Oliver into the front court. Has a step, drives, and delivers. Chantrell Oliver makes it 17-14. Three-point contest with 6:12 to go. Fans who are in attendance this afternoon making a lot of noise. May have distracted the Wildcats on that possession. So Firebirds again with the chance to cut their deficit to one or even possibly tie things up. And we have a whistle and I think something going on with the shot clock. So right now the shot clock shows 29, and certainly more than 1 second had gone off since they inbounded the ball. They reset the shot clock to 26 seconds. Game clock just under 6 minutes at 5:59. This is game one of two this afternoon. UDC men will hit the court a half hour after this one ends to take on the men from Daemen College. First conference game for both the men and women. For these Daemen teams, it is their second conference game. Wildcat women just fell at LIU Post on Wednesday night in their first conference game of the season. Tunstall gets fouled on the shot from the baseline. She will head to the line for two. Deanna Tunstall, a junior from Willingboro, New Jersey. Comes up short on the first attempt. She had not shot a free throw in any of the Firebirds' previous seven games this year. Tunstall, one of five Firebirds returning from last year's squad that went 21-9 and lost in the semifinal round of the East Coast Conference Tournament right here at the UDC Sports Complex. So Firebirds now within two after Tunstall goes one of two from the line. Jumper from the elbow rims out. Rebound hauled down by Tunstall. Tunstall has done a great job on the boards this afternoon. Firebirds came into this game as a team being out-rebounded by about four rebounds per game. Three from the corner is good. Bianca White, the Silver Spring native, puts UDC ahead by one, 18-17. Halfway through this second quarter. Collin plays give and go with Pringle. Heinl thought about the three from the corner. Decided she wanted a better look. Maybe this one? It's up and in and answers right back. That's a way to silence a crowd. Jordan Heinl came into this game a 30% three-point shooter on the year. So it's Daemen ahead by two, 20-18, 4:31 to go in the second. Coleman, jab steps, drives, and gets fouled. Was it before the shot or as she went up with it? Looks like it was as she went up with it. And that brings us to the under five media timeout. Firebirds trail by two, it's 20-18. You're watching UDC Firebirds women's basketball here on University of the District of Columbia Television. It is Kaya Coleman heading to the line for UDC. Chance to try and tie this game up. Coleman, 6 of 10 from the free throw line through the Firebirds' first seven games. Native of Laurel, Maryland. Transferred to UDC from Shaw prior to the start of the season. She's played in all eight games for UDC. And has started in three of them, but she can't hit either free throw. So wasted opportunity to tie things up there for the Firebirds. 4:18 left in this first half of play. Pringle dishes off to McDonald, back to Pringle. McDonald can't find an opening, nearly has her pass picked off. Just one on the shot clock, and it's an air ball, meaning a 30-second shot clock violation. Superb defense there by UDC, forcing the turnover. Now can the Firebirds capitalize? They've done a good job of forcing turnovers all afternoon long, working against the zone themselves. Oliver, bounce pass right, now into the corner. White the three. She just hit one from that corner. Can't get it to fall this time. White now 1 of 4 from downtown. Pollock works around the perimeter. Oliver nearly with the steal. Now Pringle, the open three, and she connects. First three of the game for Pringle. She now has 5 points. No one in double digits yet in terms of scoring. Nifty move by White. She got decked to the floor as she released that shot, but no call. Surprised about that. McDonald makes it back-to-back triples for the Wildcats, and it's 26-18 with 2:40 remaining in the half. As a team, Daemen now 4 of 11 from deep, and we have a timeout called by UDC, their first timeout called this game. Folks, at the University of the District of Columbia, the entire city is our campus. From the new community college and workforce development programs to the extension services and more, the university is active in every ward of the city, educating and enriching the lives of students, neighbors, and stakeholders. For more information, visit the UDC website at www.udc.edu. That was a full timeout called by UDC. They will have 3 remaining, still all 4 timeouts left for Daemen. Firebirds as a team shooting 28.6% from the field this afternoon. They are 2 of 8 from distance. That'd be 25%, and they're 4 of 8 from the free throw line. Daemen shooting 52.4% from the floor, 36.4% from deep. So better shooting numbers from Daemen, but they have not yet been to the free throw line. Defensive foul called on the Wildcats, team's 5th in the quarter. It will stay UDC basketball on the floor. Pardon me, team's 4th foul of the quarter. First personal called against Alexis Perdue. Getting her first minutes for Daemen. Oliver dribbles right, screen set. Now fires the deep, 2 and connects. Makes it 26-20, a 6-point game. 2:05 remaining in the half. McDonald works it around the perimeter. Oliver leads the way for UDC with 9 points. She's 3 of 10 from the field. Perdue has her shot blocked. Oliver recovers the loose ball. Now we'll slow the tempo down as she just crosses half court. Screen set by Anderson. And she's called for an offensive foul, moving screen. So Firebirds turn it over for the 9th time this game. 4 fewer turnovers than Daemen. Daemen with their 13 turnovers have led to 10 Firebirds points. Daemen has only gotten 2 points off the Firebirds' 9 turnovers. deep three from straight away is good. A very deep three-point attempt by Sydney Jones, the native of Clifton Springs, New York. Does not matter. No hesitation. She delivers to make it a nine-point game. Now the Firebirds turn it over yet again. Jones with the steal. She'll hand off to Heinold with under a minute to go in the half. Pringle dishes wide to McDonald. She'll drive, and her pass kicked out of bounds. So we'll stay Daemen basketball with 15 on the shot clock, 47 seconds. All that remains on the first half game clock. Will be McDonald at inbound with Kaya Coleman guarding her. Finds a wide open Heinold, who's then whistled for a travel. So turnover number 14 for the Wildcats. See if the Firebirds can capitalize, maybe make it a 7-point game headed into the break. Oliver swings left to Coleman, back to Oliver. Now finds Anderson on top of the arc to Coleman, the three, and she delivers. Forget a 7-point game, how about a 6-point game? Shot clock has been turned off. Pump fake by Pringle. She finds Jones on top of the arc. Now Pringle works against Coleman. 10 seconds, spins in the lane, fires, cannot deliver. But a great job coming in, stealing the rebound away was McDonald. And that results in a layup right before the buzzer, converted by Jordan Heinel. So second chance points looming large here at the end of the half for Daemen. And at the break, they lead by 8, 31-23. You've been watching UDC Firebirds women's basketball here on University of the District of Columbia television.
We're building an advanced public system of higher learning that serves the community of the District of Columbia. We selected all of those words very carefully because they all have important meanings. Because none of it really works unless you have a public higher education system that can connect it all together. Well, one of the best kept secrets about the University of the District of Columbia is that we have many quality programs. Our workforce development unit is of a high quality and puts people in jobs each and every day. Our land grant unit, which is serving constituents all over the district, we're the only urban land grant institution in the country. I think that we have all the pieces that we can put together in a way that will allow us to take best practices, best tools, and really wipe the slate clean and redesign ourselves as an advanced public system of higher learning that can serve the district in a way that allows us to be a model of higher education in a city that wants to be a model city for the rest of the country.
Being a champion takes more than skill, more than endless drills, more than using your head. Being a champion takes the heart to give it your all, the agility to thrive from any angle, and the relentless drive to be the best. Welcome to Division II, where the pursuit is yours to create, and the question isn't, can you do it? It's, will you?
Eli Perlstein welcoming you back to the UDC Sports Complex as we get set for the second half of play between your UDC women's basketball team and the women from Daemen College. Firebirds trail by 8, 31-23 here at the start of the second half. Leading scorer for UDC on the afternoon, Chantrell Oliver with 9 points. Jaslyn Rollins leads the way with 4 rebounds for Daemen. It is Jordan Heinold who leads the way with 10 points and 4 rebounds. So she leads in both those categories. Einold, however, not touching the ball yet. There she goes to start the half. She chucks up a 3, misses off the side iron. And deflected out of bounds by Daemen. So it'll be UDC basketball. Deja Anderson to inbound. Firebirds as a team in the first half shot 34.8% from the field, 33% from 3, and 50% from the free throw line. Daemen shot 50% from the field, 41.7% from 3, did not attempt a free throw. Oliver dishes out to Nyasia Anderson. She gets it cross court. Now Oliver, the 3 from the corner, comes up short, but Nyasia Anderson is there with the rebound. Coleman chucks up the 3, too strong. Another offensive rebound by Anderson. And it looked like she may have dribbled it off her foot. And they do say she was the last to touch it before it went out of bounds. So remains 31-23, now under 9 minutes to go here in the third quarter of play. And we have a whistle, foul away from the basketball. And it goes against Daemen. Notice during halftime that we have a special guest in attendance, as it's the head coach of current Firebirds head coach Juan Dixon, his former head coach at Maryland, Gary Williams, actually sitting in the bleachers this afternoon, taking on Firebirds action today, supporting his former pupil. The shot from the baseline won't go, and we have a foul called on the Firebirds. Team's first, second personal going against Deja Anderson. For UDC, just one player in any sort of foul trouble from the first half. That'd be Jasmine Rollins. She committed 3 personals. For Daemen, Jesse DeWaters committed 2 personals. No one else with more than 1. Drive and underhand layup converted by Leah McDonald for the Wildcats. Makes it a 10-point game, 33-23. 8:10 to go in the quarter. Just inside the arc. Deja Anderson let it fly, couldn't connect. Firebirds yet to convert in the half. Offensive rebound snagged down by McDonald. Pringle picks up her dribble. Now Saba drives. Good defense on her by Oliver. McDonald trapped by a double team, and that forces a timeout to be called by Daemen. Their first timeout used this afternoon will leave them with 2 remaining. They didn't call a timeout in the first half, but both teams, whether they use one or not, go down to 3 timeouts remaining at the start of the second half. Folks, the University of the District of Columbia is the only public university in the nation's capital and the only urban land-grant university in the United States. UDC is comprised of a community college, School of Engineering and Applied Sciences, School of Business and Public Administration, a College of Arts and Sciences, a College of Agriculture, Urban Sustainability and Environmental Sciences, and the David A. Clark School of Law. For more information, visit the UDC website at www.udc.edu. Looking at the scoring breakdown by quarters, Daemen led 15-10 after the first quarter. They outscored the Firebirds 16-3 in the second. And they've outscored the Firebirds 2-0 thus far here in the third quarter of play. Out on the court for UDC, Oliver, Deanna Tunstall, Jasmine Rollins. So they're going a little bit bigger now. Nyasia Anderson. Jones drives, can't convert. The other Firebird I didn't mention who's out there is Bianca White. Bianca White hit a couple of threes in the first half. Bianca and Bailey are actually twins, while Nyasia and Deja are not twins. Nyasia slightly older than Deja, but both are freshmen. So two sets of sisters as part of the freshman class for this UDC program. A young team for head coach Juan Dixon to work with. Travel is the call on Leah McDonald. So it remains a 10-point game, 7:01 remaining here in the third quarter of play. Dantrell Oliver will work it into the front court. Dishes off to White, back to Oliver. Oliver drives to the free throw line, kicks out wide. Now White tries to get into the lane and draws a foul. Second team foul called on Daemen this half. So Firebirds will inbound from the baseline. Pass gets into Oliver. Oliver dishes off to White for three, comes up short. Firebirds, no hesitation on launching those threes. They've been doing it all season. Thus far, they're at this afternoon, they're connecting at a 25% clip. Just about it, what they've been hitting on this season from three. They don't have much size to work with this year. Speaking of threes, there's one from the corner by Jones. That doesn't go. Now Firebirds pushing the pace. And as a result, Nyasia Anderson draws the foul. That stops the clock with 6:02 remaining in the quarter. Firebirds shooting 50% from the free throw line. This is the first trip to the line for Nyasia Anderson, who is scoreless on the game so far. Despite averaging nearly 12 points per game coming into this contest. She's able to hit the first. Make that two in a row. So the older sister of Deja has the first 2 points of the second half for UDC. Very low scoring third quarter of play thus far. Jones had a split second look at another three if she had wanted. Saba has been kept in check all day by UDC. They've done a good job guarding her. Heinold, on the other hand, gets open again and converts. She's having herself a day. Now with 12 points, it's back to a 10-point game, 35-25. 5:22 left. Oliver has a screen set by Rollins. Frees her up for three, and she converts. Oliver now with 12 points, already above her season average of 9 a game. Oliver picking up the slack this afternoon. Is there anyone else who can help her out, however? That's the question. Three off the fingertips of Jones came out flat. Now Pringle with an open look, can't convert. And we've got a jump ball on the floor. Nice job by Sarah Saba getting her hands in there. It looked like it would have been a clear rebound for Rollins. I don't think Rollins was expecting hands to get in there as quickly as they did. So that takes us to the under 5 media timeout. You're watching UDC Firebirds women's basketball here on University of the District of Columbia television. Chantrell Oliver missed all of last season due to injury. She averaged 6.5 a game during her sophomore season in 2014-15. Averaging career high of 9 points per game coming into this game and already has 12 for UDC to lead the way. Firebirds trailing by 7, 4:33 to go. Oliver dishes off to Tunstall. Now Anderson drives, kicks wide, Tunstall the three, comes up short. Rebound knocked out of bounds. Will stay Firebirds possession. Tunstall inbounds, gets it to Oliver. Pass nearly broken up. Oliver has her shot rim out. Now Pringle quickly into the front court for Daemen. Dishes off to Pollock, back to Pringle. Pollock open for a three, got her defender on her feet, but that caused Pollock to travel as a result. It was a good pump fake, and then just moved her feet before she could put the ball on the floor. Anderson works it around the perimeter. The three from the left wing. Good. Bianca White, her third three of the game. Or pardon me, third bucket of the game, second three. And she now has 8. Second most points for UDC this afternoon. Saba way off on that shot attempt. But it will stay Daemen basketball. 3:16 left to go in the quarter. Firebirds now 5 of 15 from downtown after that three by White. Pollock has her inbounds pass intercepted. So Firebirds come away with the steal. White drives baseline, good feed to Anderson, who draws the foul. For UDC, just their second steal of the afternoon as a team. They came into this game ranked last in the ECC in terms of steals per game, averaging 7, but they're on a pace to steal even fewer than 7 this afternoon. That being said, only 1 steal for Daemen thus far. So both these teams not ranking highly this afternoon in the steals department. You see a couple of factors working against them. They normally don't get many steals, and their opponent, Daemen, is last in the ECC when it comes to allowing their opponents to get steals. Oliver swings left to Anderson. Rollins sets the screen, gets Anderson open, and she delivers. And the deficit is down to 2. So Firebirds making a nice run here towards the end of this third quarter. Chance of defense starting from the fans in the stands. Gringle. Travel is the call. That was called on Pollock. 2 subs coming in now for the Wildcats. Sydney Jones checks in, as does Alexis Perdue. Oliver left alone to bring it up. 2:04 left. Anderson back to Oliver. Naeja gets into the paint, puts up a shot, has it blocked by Heinel, who's off to the races the other way, and then gets the ball stripped. Oliver gets it right back for the Firebirds. Left open for the three, comes up short. That was a shot that didn't really look like she wanted to take, but she was so wide open that she just had to let it fly. But if you looked at her feet, she wasn't square up to the hoop. And that's one of those rare situations where even though you have an open look, you either got to pass it up or take a dribble to set your feet, because her feet were crooked and that threw off her shot. Oliver now checks out of the game. Kaya Coleman in for her. Coleman, Rollins, Tunstall in the backcourt. Bailey White and Bianca White, the twins, in the backcourt for UDC. Purdue gets it off to Pringle. She works it around the perimeter. Now Heinel, cross court to Purdue. She drives baseline, splits two defenders, and draws the foul. Nice move by Purdue getting through the two defenders, Coleman and Rollins, much to the crowd's dismay. Purdue unable to hit the first free throw. Alexis Purdue from Lindenhurst, New York. She's a freshman. Had not attempted a free throw prior to today, this season. Can't hit either. Those were the first two free throw attempts for Daemen this game. They've been shooting a lot of perimeter shots, have not attacked the basket much. So it remains a two-point game, under a minute remaining in this third quarter. Bailey White can't get the bucket to fall. Now Tunstall, out to Coleman for three. It's short. Rebound was knocked up. Tunstall had a shot at it, but couldn't find it. Back the other way, Saba fouled as she attacks the rim. And two more free throws coming up for the Wildcats. Saba took a hard foul to the ground, shaking up a bit, but she looks like she's okay. Given a second to catch her breath and shake off any pain. Referee's making sure she's all right. Saba came into this game shooting 63% from the free throw line. Hits on the first. Saba now with 5 points, well below her season average of 15.8. Firebirds have done a great job shutting her down. She goes one of two at the line. So it's a 3-point Daemen lead. 5-second difference between shot clock and game clock as we wind down to the end of the third. Coleman attacks and hits off the glass. 1-point game, 18 seconds to go. Shot clock turned off. Most likely Daemen will hold for the final possession of the quarter. Saba drives. Can't convert off the glass. 4 seconds left. Pass ahead, broken up. And that will do it for the quarter. But a great third quarter for UDC. It started off slow for both teams. The building has come alive as the Firebirds have come alive as well. They have trimmed their deficit to one as the Firebirds trailed by as many as 8 at the half. Now they trail by just 1. So they best Daemen by 7 in the quarter. You're watching UDC Firebirds women's basketball here on University of the District of Television. You're watching Firebirds women's basketball here on University of the District of Columbia Television.
Public education is an opportunity like no other. When it works, it's absolutely magical. When it works on this campus, the magic is just unending. I am a product of public education. I went to public schools from K through graduate school. And I can't imagine district residents wouldn't have the same options that I had as a kid in the state of Ohio. I think that UDC is special because it marries the best of all that is Washington, D.C. When you cross the campus, you cross students from every ward of the city, every type of neighborhood. We represent, in terms of student populations, about 100 countries around the world. So you can hear almost any language. You can see every color of the rainbow on this campus. You can hear every kind of dream of hope. You can hear every kind of story of triumph.
Being a champion takes more than skill, more than endless drills, more than using your head. Being a champion takes the heart to give it your all, the agility to thrive from any angle, and the relentless drive to be the best. Welcome to Division II, where the pursuit is yours to create. And the question isn't, can you do it? It's, will you?
Firebirds with a great third quarter. Can they match that intensity here in the fourth? We'll find out. 10 minutes to go. Firebirds looking for win number two on the air. Daemen looking for win number three. Jones works it around the perimeter. Purdue works it inside. Now back outside. Heinold the three. Heinold has been money all game now with 15 points. 3 of 6 from distance. Leading scorer in this ball game. The freshman from Hamburg, New York. Oliver, not doing too shabby herself. She gets the layup to fall. She has 14, one behind Heinold. And UDC within two. Gotta love the enthusiasm from the crowd here at the UDC Sports Complex this afternoon. Former Maryland coach Gary Williams, part of that crowd today. Watching his pupil Juan Dixon lead this UDC squad in just his second home game of the season. Firebirds will be at home for the next little while as Oliver falls down on that layup attempt. Jones has the ball poked away from behind. Refs are staying, it's still Daemen basketball. Firebirds' next game is here at home against Glenville State on Monday night. Then they host Roberts Wesleyan on Wednesday, so first of 3 in a row at home for UDC. And 4 of their next 5 games are all here at the UDC Sports Complex, so a lot of home cooking for the Firebirds coming up. 2 subs coming in for UDC. Deja Anderson. And Bianca White both back in. Saba works it left to Jones. Screen set by Saba. She couldn't get open on the attempted roll to the hoop. Again, Heinold, and she has been money all day. Firebirds want timeout. They cannot keep leaving Heinold open. She has been hitting her shot today. They've got to find a way to close out on her. She now has 18 points, 4 three-pointers made by Jordan Heinold. Folks, the University of the District of Columbia extends beyond its campus footprint, offering easy access to world-famous monuments, political intrigue, and cultural attractions everywhere you look. And education at UDC opens doors to opportunities that can only be found in the nation's capital. For more information, visit the UDC website, www.udc.edu. UDC-TV.edu. And folks, be sure to follow UDC Athletics on Facebook, on Twitter, at UDC Firebird Fans, and on YouTube, at UDC Athletics 1. .44-37. Daemen, where would they be without Jordan Heinel this afternoon? 18 points on 7 of 13 shooting from the field, 4 of 7 from downtown. One of two Wildcats in double figures. They've really needed her production with the lack of production from Sarah Saba, who they normally rely on so heavily. Also, Leah McDonald with the somewhat down game. 4 points below her season average thus far. They're still able to maintain this 7-point advantage. Three from Naisha. Anderson is good. Anderson now with 7 for the Firebirds. It's her first 3-pointer of the game, and it's a 4-point contest. Both teams starting to heat up from three. Got 7:46 remaining in the contest. Firebirds, who went 12-4 at home last year, looking for their first home win of the season. Off-balance shot by Pringle won't go. Firebirds now a chance to cut their deficit to 2. Oliver uses a screen by Tunstall, now gives it up and gets it right back. She'll drive, kick wide, White the 3 off the mark. And it's Purdue comes away with the rebound for the Wildcats. Jones to Pringle. Purdue back to Pringle. Like the ball movement from the Wildcats, Saba can't finish on the layup attempt. Anderson splits two defenders and banks it home. Makes it 44-42 with 6:45 to go. Saba to the free throw line. Miscommunication between Saba and Heinel as they were standing less than a foot apart. Now Saba drives, gets bumped on the layup, and she's still able to convert. So a chance at a 3-point play for Sarah Saba. His name to this week's ECC honor roll. First team all ECC standout from a year ago. Saba ranks 5th in the ECC in points per game and 5th in blocks. Coming into today, also 3rd in turnovers per game. Gets the free throw to go. So a 5-point game with 6:20 left. Oliver comes up a little short on her layup attempt. If you're UDC, you want it in the hands of Oliver. She's the one who's been able to be consistently effective offensively all afternoon. Shot clock down to 10. Saba with the 3. Short. That is Coleman who secures the rebound for UDC. 5:46 left. Anderson drives towards the baseline, gets the layup, and draws the foul. The clock stops with 5:36 remaining. It is Naisha Anderson heading to the line to try and make it a 3-point play. Anderson 2 of 4 from the free throw line this afternoon. That's big, makes it a 2-point game. Anderson now into double digits with 11. She was silent for the first half. Anderson with no points in the first half. All 11 have come here in the second half, but she has come alive. Firebird's leading scorer on the season, starting to show why. Heinel, beautiful pass to McDonald, cutting to the rim, and she's able to convert the easy layup. 49-45, 5:13 remaining. Oliver plays give and go with Deja Anderson. Now foul called on the Wildcats. Stops the clock with 5:07 left. It will be Firebirds basketball from the baseline. Coleman inbounds to Rollins, who gets the free, who gets the layup and the foul. Jaslyn Rollins now with 4 points. She'll make her first trip to the free throw line today. Rollins, the native of Ypsilanti, Michigan, where she attended Lincoln Senior High School. And a lane violation called on UDC. Their second lane violation this afternoon. Think about it, both have happened with UDC shooting free throws. It's a 2-point game. UDC makes both those free throws. We're tied right now. Those could be costly in the long run. McDonald too strong on the layup attempt. Coleman open for a three, comes up short. Rollins fighting for it. Now Anderson blocked from behind. Coleman with the steal and the layup, and we're tied at 49. Timeout called by Daemen. Their head coach, Jennifer Banker, in her first year, trying to silence the crowd as she feels the momentum slipping away from her. Firebirds have had tremendous effort here in the second half. Folks, since opening its doors in 2009, the University of the District of Columbia Community College continuously affirms its mission to provide opportunities for students to obtain the requisite skills of today's workforce and to prepare them for the demands of tomorrow. For more information, visit the UDC website, www.udc.edu. Saba plays give and go with Pringle. Now McDonald takes it to the top of the arc where she hands off to Purdue. This gym is loud, folks. Firebird faithful doing all they can to support their women this afternoon. Free ball won't go, but an offensive rebound by McDonald. Huge offensive board. 4:02 left. Saba. Pringle controlling it, the rock at the top of the arc. Now Saba down low, fighting for the loose ball. We have a jump ball called. And which way is the arrow going, folks? It's going in favor of the Firebirds. That means next jump ball will go Daemen's way. Important to note here down the stretch. There's 3:41 left. Oliver dishes off to Coleman. Juan Dixon on the sideline shouting out instructions for the play. Step back jumper by Anderson, who's been red hot here in the second half. That time comes up empty. They remain tied at 49. 3:20 left. Firebirds have been in a number of close games this season. They lost by 4 on Monday night at Virginia State. Their lone win at Lincoln in Pennsylvania was a 2-point win. So they're used to these close contests. Daemen had a 6-point loss at Notre Dame College. That was their closest game this season, so an edging close game goes the way of the Firebirds. White open for a split second from three. She pulled the trigger, but can't get it to fall. Now timeout called by the Firebirds, leaving them with one remaining. Both teams with one timeout left, with 2:44 remaining. Well, folks, I've told you a bunch about new UDC head coach Juan Dixon, the former Maryland standout who led the Terrapins to the national title in 2002. But let me tell you a little bit about the head coach for Daemen, Jennifer Banker. She's also in her first year at the helm of this program. Overall, her sixth year as a collegiate head coach, she guided the Penn State Barand women's basketball team from 1988 through 1993. She has coached at all three levels of the NCAA. That includes stints as an assistant coach. And she's even coached at the high school level. Overall, as a collegiate head coach, she is 66-65 entering today. Inbounds pass deflected out of bounds. Will remain UDC basketball. This is one of five contests involving East Coast Conference teams going on this afternoon. That's a backcourt violation on UDC. So it'll be Wildcats basketball. Pringle. Whistled for the travel before the pass. I believe that travel call was on Pringle, not McDonald, who she passed it to. So 2:34 left. Tied at 49. Oliver. Two players come to set a screen. Had her choice of which way she wanted to go. White. The three ball. Won't go off the back iron. Pringle works it around the perimeter to Saba. Back to Pringle. Pump face. Now works it right to Jones. Saba again. Cross court, nearly thrown away. And now Heinold, who's been money all game. Appropriate that she breaks the tie, makes it 52-49. Now 21 points for the freshman Heinold, who came in averaging only 5.5 points a game. Where did this performance come from? Oliver trying to answer, she does. Chantrell Oliver says, anything you can do, I can do better, and knocks this game at 52 with a minute 26 left. Oliver now with 17 in the game. Jones gets it out wide, the three too strong. Long rebound recovered by DJ Anderson. She'll pop, tried to pass it back. Didn't realize it was the wrong colored shirt behind her. Now a travel is called as Saba slipped, so it will be UDC basketball with a minute 9 remaining. Leah McDonald checks out of the game for the Wildcats. Anderson gets it into Oliver. She drives in the lane, dishes off to Rowland, who hits the layup from the left side. And UDC with their first lead in a very long time. 54-52, under a minute left. Crowd can start to feel it. If you're the Wildcats, you want to get into the hands of Arnold, who's open for three. Let's go another. This time she's off the mark. And it's White who's thrown to the ground as she came away with the rebound. Fourth team foul committed by Daemen. So ball will stay on the floor for UDC. Next foul will mean free throws. Anderson gets it in to Oliver. Oliver makes her way to the front court. Time now on the side of the Firebirds. There's a 10-second difference between shot clock and game clock. Oliver drives, Kicks out to Anderson. She tries to pass into the corner for White. Pass deflected out of bounds. 10 remaining on the shot clock, 20.9 on the game clock. Each team does have one timeout left. Firebirds electing to not call theirs. Don't want to give the defense a chance to set up. Oliver, screen set by Rollins. She drives, kicks out wide. White drives baseline, layup won't go. Rollins, the offensive rebound, and a foul called. Huge offensive board for Jaslyn Rollins. Now I'll have a chance to make it a two-possession game with some free throws. For Rollins, that is her 10th rebound of the game. She has 6 points. This is her first trip to the line. And she's good on the first. So a 3-point UDC lead. Firebirds losing the rebound battle right now by 4. So they're one better in terms of offensive rebounds. That one rebound difference, the last rebound there by Rollins. Huge, huge offensive board. And the Firebirds are able to escape with their second win of the season. That's really a big reason why. As well as the play of Chantrell Oliver this afternoon, 17 points to lead the way. She has been terrific. And the Firebirds, who have outscored Daemen in this fourth quarter 20-16. In the half, they've outscored Daemen 32-21. Last time the Firebirds led in this game, prior to when they took the lead here in the fourth, was when it was 8-7 after a Chantrell Oliver jump shot with 5:05 remaining in the first quarter. It's 15-10 after one. And at the half, it was 31-23. Rollins can't make the second, but another offensive board. Long rebounds, huge for UDC down the stretch, and now it's Nyasia Anderson to try and make it a two-possession game. Nyasia Anderson. Good. Gets the friendly roll on the first attempt to make it a 4-point game. She now has 13 points and is 4 of 6 from the free throw line. Unable to hit the second, and a timeout called by the Wildcats. With 9.9 left, Wildcats need a quick score and then a quick foul to stay in this one. As we take a look at the road ahead for both teams, we'll begin with the Wildcats, who have one more road game in this game, in this stretch of 6 road contests in a row. They are at the University of Bridgeport next Saturday, December 10th, before finally playing their first home game of the season, December 14th, against the New York Institute of Technology. Firebirds, meanwhile, remain here at home, will host Glenville State on Monday night. Then they host Roberts Wesleyan in their second conference game of the year on Wednesday night at 5 p.m. Both the Glenville State and Roberts Wesleyan games are at 5 p.m. Can be seen here on University of the District of Columbia television. Mentioned there are a bunch of other games going around the East Coast Conference this afternoon. A couple of finals to tell you about. St. Thomas Aquinas fell in a non-ECC game at Caldwell, 79-54. Wildcats have to move quickly. Saba, not moving quick enough. Hands off to Pringle, whose layup is good as time expires. And so your final will be UDC 56, Wildcats 54. The Firebirds pick up their first conference win of the season as they improve to 2-6 overall, 1-0 in ECC play, and 1-1 here at home. Daemen falls to 2-5 on the season, 0-2 in conference play, and 0-5 when playing away from home.